Hello everyone, welcome to Spicey Kitchen, the place where you can learn how to make simple, cost-effective and tasty food. And today I'm going to show you how to make muyal curry or rabbit curry. This is a very special recipe where this involves a two-step process where you first marinate the rabbit and then fry it and then you pressure cook it to make the final muyal curry. So here we go. To prepare the marination mixture, we need the following ingredients: garlic masala powder, coriander powder, chilli powder, turmeric powder, pepper powder, onions, ginger, and lemon or lime. You also need to add salt. First of all, you need to mix all these ingredients together using a mixer or blender, and you need to run your mixer till you get a smooth, fine paste. Please remember that we are not going to use all of this mixture or of this spice paste for marination, but we will just use half of it. The other half we will keep it aside for later processes. So here you can see that I'm squeezing lemon and I'm going to make a paste, and I'm going to add salt to it so that it's complete. And then you need to cut rabbit to small pieces so that we can apply the marination properly. There are two ways. One way is that you keep it marinated for 30 minutes on room temperature, or you can cover it with a plastic wrap and you can keep it refrigerated as well. It's up to you. So here you can see that I'm just taking half of the spice mix I've prepared for marination. The other half I'll keep it aside. Now the next step is to shallow fry the marinated rabbit. So you take a frying pan, add cooking oil to that, and then when the cooking oil is really hot, you add your marinated rabbit pieces into it. Make sure to flip the pieces over so that both sides get cooked properly. Now, once you fry all the marinated pieces, keep that aside, and into the same pan, add a little bit more cooking oil. We are going to saute onions, add salt to it so that onions get cooked properly, very quickly. And then, once the onions turn light brown in color, you could add the remaining spice mix that we have kept aside, the half part that we have kept aside. You have to put that into it, and we are going to fry it till the rawness of that goes away. And you can see that when it's ready, oil will start to come out from this mixture. Now at that time, we are ready for the next stage of making this rabbit curry. It's very important that you cook this spice mix properly, otherwise there will be a raw taste in it. So that shouldn't be there. So you can see a close-up view of how the spice mix should look like when it's ready. The next step is to pressure cook this cooked spice mix and the shallow fried rabbit. So take pressure cooker, add a little bit of water to that. Add the shallow fried rabbit meat pieces into it, followed by the stir fried spice mix into that. Depending upon how much gravy you need, you can add a little bit of butter, but in any case, I think roughly 100 milliliters of water should be sufficient. Then you need to cook this. Rabbit meat requires a high heat and a little bit of cooking time compared to other meats. So I recommend to cook it for 15 to 20 minutes on medium flame. You'll have to figure that out depending upon the type of pressure cooker you use. Now, once that is ready, once you cook it, you can open it, and here you can see that very nicely cooked rabbit meat is available here. The next step, the next thing we need to do is to add coconut milk. Here I have refrigerated coconut milk, so that's why it's in cubes, but in your case it may be just the freshly made coconut milk or the one that is available in a tin. Whichever may be the case, just add coconut milk to this mixture. And coconut milk gives a very nice taste to this curry, a nice texture as well. And after adding coconut milk, within say 5 minutes, your rabbit curry will be ready. And you can serve this with chapati or with rice, whatever you like. I'm sure you will enjoy cooking this and you will try this at home. Please do remember to subscribe my channel, comment. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.